All right, Zach Posen is here, and I'm not going to get Zach in trouble, but you were making the observation, because I think people in New York generally feel we are the schlubbier coast.
Right, the more casual.
More casual coast. But your thought in terms of the way men dress in Los Angeles vis-a-vis...
I think there's a lot more like male grooming here.
That's true.
We're better moisturized.
Probably good sunscreen.
Right, 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 right.
Good
hair. Are we better looking?
Oh, that's hard. I mean, we're in the glamour town.
Right.
So, you know,
in
some ways... You come here for a dream.
It's true, Zach, and isn't it amazing, like, if you go to a restaurant or even a Subway, the person behind the counter is drop-dead gorgeous. You know, they came here from wherever. Everywhere you go, there's really good-looking people here.
Well, I mean, it's an image town.
Yeah.
Partially. Listen, I think there's beautiful people everywhere.
Speaking of good-looking people, happy birthday to Zach.
Oh,
happy birthday, Zach.
Thank you.
Big party. Look, there's a couple people.
Yeah, with Heidi. Okay.
Yes.
Right.
Most supportive, amazing friend in the world. And with Paris.
Oh, my goodness.
And, you know, and James.
James. Yeah. Was it fun? What'd you do?
We had a really great time. I mean, the Elizabeth Taylor AIDS Foundation is an incredible charity. You know, I'm now an ambassador for them. Mm. And I am going to work very hard, go to Washington, and, you know, try to raise awareness and funds, you know, hopefully to, you know, end the AIDS epidemic.
We're going to talk a little bit about fashion, and then we're not going to talk about fashion.
Okay.
Talk to me about House of Z.
House of Z. It is a documentary about my career and life to date.
But
the ups, the downs, the good times, the bad times.
But you're 27.
But I'm here.
But the fact that there's a documentary about all your work and you're
37.
But okay, I was going to say, you're well under 40. Isn't that pretty impressive?
You know, it was an odd choice to do, but I think I started very young. And, you know, it's been an amazing journey. I've been challenged, you know, almost, you know, family challenges,
sure.
not speaking with them, business challenges, the balance of art and commerce and resilience and creativity and art and commerce.
We're going to look at a clip in just a second. I don't know if it's like looking amongst one's children. Do you look at an outfit that you designed 10 years ago and like, wow, that was really good, or gee, what
Yeah,
what was
absolutely. Yeah, because it was pure.
Right.
You know, it didn't have all the nonsense in it. And you think, oh, it was just, that was just a great dress that a woman loved to wear.
Right.
But, you know, you learn. You learn to appreciate simplicity, to learn about women. I'm in dressing rooms every day.
Right. What do you learn about them?
Oh, you learn their neuroses. You learn their fantasies. You know, and how they want to present themselves. And then you help them. I'm interested in presenting powerful women. Women that are feeling confident and are in touch with their creativity.
All right, here's a look at House of Z.
The front rows were filled with the who's who of the entire industry.
Could you predict big things with that?
I think he's gonna be a major star.
When a fire starts to burn, right, and it starts to spread.
You know, from the start, he was a Vogue baby. They really embraced him.
We loved him. We loved his spirit. We took Zach to power. Zach was as excited as could be. And who wouldn't be? You sort of feel, wow, and in Paris on top of it.
Let's get these cameras over here, get some splashing going on. It's fashion week.
And what are you wearing now?
Zach.
You like the show?
Yeah, it was so fun.
Wow, would you be where you were without the support of, is Vogue like the grand determiner of all things?
One of them, for sure, absolutely. I mean, they've built a whole, you know, system. You know, in a way, Vogue is like the MGM system.
Right.
Back in the day here, you know, Anna Wintour was incredibly instrumental. There were many people. You know, it takes a village.
All right.
And takes luck and takes risks.
And takes talent.
And takes talent and drive and resilience.
All right. From that, what you describe as your detox from fashion, you're an accomplished cook. The book is called Cooking with Zach. What is the first recipe I turn to? Was the chocolate bread, chocolate croissant bread pudding.
I'm gonna have to come back here and cook it.
Yes, absolutely. Are you kidding? Come back.
I'm gonna come back here and cook.
How's tomorrow sound?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you noodle in the kitchen or what? How'd you get good?
You know, in middle school, I watched a lot of cooking TV. I was very dyslexic growing up. Cookbooks were visual. And I love using my hands. My father cooked at home. And it just developed. I cooked at the James Beard House.
Wow.
Started cooking with chefs. And I thought, you know, I wanted to tell a story. I wasn't going to write, you know, an autobiography. That would be absurd at this moment. But I thought, let me do something I'm really passionate about.
Is there this compare and contrast between
fashion people eat? I just want to tell
that,
fashion people eat.
But fashion models don't eat.
They do.
Okay.
They do. I promise.
All right.
You've seen it.
Very good.
I've seen it. I've cooked for them.
Right.
We will tell you this. You can catch House of Z, the documentary, at Vogue.com. Zach will be signing copies of his book, Cooking with Zach, tonight. Where else would you sign it? Forget Barnes & Noble. Williams Sonoma.
Oh, perfect.
That's Beverly Hills.
That's exactly. Very good parking garage. The best parking garage in Beverly Hills
good to
is
know.
Next to that Williams.
Yeah.
Very good. Zach, really a pleasure.
Oh, thank you for having me.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Such a pleasure.
Bye.